First time trying Starbucks coffee, and it's instant Starbucks coffee. Got a dash of almond milk. It's actually really good. Intro, man. Now that sound is actually the heater, so don't mind that, but it's pretty cold. Warm up, you know. But anyway, what is good, guys? Welcome back to the channel. I hope you guys are all doing well today. My name is Paul Archer. I'm an aspiring natural bodybuilder looking to compete in 2023-2024, and this is my journey to the stage. So deadlifts on the cards today. We're going for a top set of 130 kilograms. Last time I did deadlifts, I got 120 for 11. And I'm only meant to aim for 5 to 9 reps. So we are going for 130 today. And I'm gonna get it. I'm gonna get it, man. As you saw in the opening scene, I tried Starbucks coffee the first time. So it was pretty good. And I also swapped my pre-workout meal with my post-workout meal. So instead of cereal post-workout, I had cereal pre-workout. And I had my bagels post-workout. Just want to see how it sits in my stomach. You know, gotta try all different things. Still the same macros, but I'll take you guys through a quick montage of the training, and then I'll show you guys my top set for the deadlifts. Let's hope I get this. I'm gonna get this deadlift, man. Let's go. Not in the game, man. Big round off his birthday, gave him a happy belated one. But we got 8, man. We got 8, man. Got another solid session in, pretty good, pretty happy with the deadlifts, pretty happy with how everything is progressing. But I thought I would just end this video on something, some of my thoughts on a recent post by this bloke from the UK. He goes by the name of James Smith, right? The reason why I feel like it's relative to me is coming from someone who really wants to compete, particularly naturally. So I just wanted to give you guys my thoughts on his one of his posts, a post that sparked a lot of controversy, right, within the bodybuilding community. If you guys, I'll put it up for you guys to have a read for yourself, because I don't know if you guys have heard of it. So you guys know what I'm talking about, have a read. Yeah, I'm just gonna give you guys my thoughts on it. So, I mean, long story short, he was basically saying how pretty much shitting on the bodybuilding community, like the whole industry, about how it breeds insecurities, and about how the people who compete are just insecure about themselves, and that he's like, he would rather you know, enjoy his croissant and, you know, diet here and there and stuff. But like, I mean, to be honest, I don't think he really knows. He doesn't have a full grab of why people actually compete. And it's very generalized, to be honest. Like, I feel like he's just literally just generalizing the sport. And I mean, some of the stuff he says is true, but it's not true for, not for everybody. And for him to generalize that, especially with his big, large following, I think that's the reason why a lot of people are sort of like responding to him and are sort of having to have a problem with it, is because of how he degrades the bodybuilding industry with his large following. Like, if it was some small person doing it, then it's different, right? But yeah, so that is the post. And I'm not gonna lie, it did make me question as to why I want to compete and why I have a passion for bodybuilding. And, you know, made me question, like, is this worth it? And like, I've come to the conclusion that yes, it is worth it. Like, his post, I mean, yeah, he did say some true stuff, but me coming into this, me aspiring to be a natural bodybuilder, aspiring to compete for the first time, I already had all of that stuff ticked off in my head. Like, I already made that decision that I was fine with not, you know, enjoying that croissant or whatever, you know, living that balanced life. Because number one, I like to challenge myself. I like to set goals that look unachievable. And, you know, in that sense, whenever I set a goal, you know, I try to accomplish it with everything that I have. So, you know, I sort of knew all of that stuff that he was saying. I knew that that's what I was expecting. That's what I was signing up for, if you want to say. I'm not sure how other people who haven't competed before, who are planning on competing for the first time, what their thoughts were on. It'd be interesting. A lot of the people I've been looking at, they've competed before and stuff and things like that. But for someone who wants to compete for the first time naturally, who's just started their journey, it has not changed my mind at all. I'm going all in, man. I'm going all into the stage, man. No one's gonna stop me, bruh. No one. No one. Try to stop me. James Smith. Yeah, like, that was just like a little spiel. Like, I mean, good points, but at the end of the day, this is my passion. This is my grind. This is my hustle. I want to build a career, not from competing, but from training, from learning about the human body, from helping other people. And that is, and the start of that is just competing. This is just the start of my whole life. This is the start of my future. But yeah, that's my little spiel. I wanted to make this like a really quick video, like a little vlog, just to get one out for you guys, and also just to let you guys know of my thoughts on it. Let me know what you guys think of his post, about his points. Do you guys agree with him in some stances, or do you think that he's just a prick? But yeah, that is pretty much it for this video, man. If you guys did enjoy this video, make sure you guys drop a like down below and comment as well. It really helps the channel grow. Thank you guys all so much for the support we've been getting some consistent views, some consistent likes. So I really appreciate every single one of you guys. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your day or your night. Stay safe, stay blessed, and most importantly, stay kind. I'll see you guys in the next one. Deuces.